Blackstone Audio presents A Hero of Our Time by Mikhail Lermontov, translated by J.H. Wisdom and Mar Murray. This book is read by Clive Chafer. Book 1. Bella, The Heart of a Russian. Chapter 1. I was travelling post from Tiflis. All the luggage I had in my cart consisted of one small portmanteau, half filled with travelling notes on Georgia. Of these, the greater part has been lost, fortunately for you, but the portmanteau itself and the rest of its contents have remained intact, fortunately for me. As I entered the Koishawa Valley, the sun was disappearing behind the snow-clad ridge of the mountains. In order to accomplish the ascent of Mount Koishawa by nightfall, my driver, an Ossete, urged on the horses indefatigably, singing zealously the while at the top of his voice. What a glorious place that valley is! On every hand are inaccessible mountains, steep yellow slopes scored by water channels, and reddish rocks draped with green ivy and crowned with clusters of plane trees. Yonder, at an immense height, is the golden fringe of the snow. Down below rolls the river Aragva, which, after bursting noisily forth from the dark and misty depths of the gorge, with an unnamed stream clasped in its embrace, stretches out like a thread of silver, its waters glistening like a snake with flashing scales. Arrived at the foot of Mount Koishawa, we stopped at a dukhan. About a score of Georgians and mountaineers were gathered there in a noisy crowd, and close by a caravan of camels had halted for the night. I was obliged to hire oxen to drag my cart up that accursed mountain, as it was now autumn, and the roads were slippery with ice. Besides, the mountain is about 2 versts in length. There was no help for it, so I hired 6 oxen and a few Ossetes. One of the latter shouldered my portmanteau, and the rest, shouting almost with one voice, proceeded to help the oxen. Following mine, there came another cart, which I was surprised to see 4 oxen pulling with the greatest ease, notwithstanding that it was loaded to the top. Behind it walked the owner, smoking a little silver-mounted Kabardian pipe. He was wearing a shaggy Circassian cap and an officer's overcoat without epaulettes, and he seemed to be about 50 years of age. The swarthiness of his complexion showed that his face had long been acquainted with Transcaucasian suns, and the premature greyness of his moustache was out of keeping with his firm gait and robust appearance. I went up to him and saluted. He silently returned my greeting and emitted an immense cloud of smoke. "We are fellow travellers, it appears." Again he bowed silently. "I suppose you are going to Stavropol?"
"Yes, sir, exactly, with government things."
"Can you tell me how it is that that heavily laden cart of yours is being drawn without any difficulty by 4 oxen, whilst 6 cattle are scarcely able to move mine, empty though it is, and with all those Ossetes helping?" He smiled slyly and threw me a meaning glance.
"You have not been in the Caucasus long, I should say."
"About 1 year," I answered. He smiled a second time. "Well?"
"Just so, sir," he answered. "They're terrible beasts, these Asiatics. You think that all that shouting means that they're helping the oxen? Why, the devil alone can make out what it is they do shout. The oxen understand, though, and if you were to yoke as many as 20, they still wouldn't budge so long as the Ossetes shouted in that way of theirs. Awful scoundrels. But what can you make of them? They love extorting money from people who happen to be travelling through here. The rogues have been spoiled. You wait and see, they will get a tip out of you as well as their hire. I know them of old. They can't get round me."
"You have been serving here a long time?"
"Yes, I was here under Alexei Petrovich," he answered, assuming an air of dignity. "I was a sub-lieutenant when he came to the line, and I was promoted 2 times during his command on account of actions against the mountaineers."
"And now?"
"Now I'm in the 3rd battalion of the line. And you yourself?"
I told him. With this, the conversation ended, and we continued to walk in silence.
We hope you enjoyed this preview. To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, use the link in the video description.